Yeah, just block things out. I see some of you are going, I'm doing this very regular, but not regular at all. And I'm all over the place. That's a tendency. To be very precise and very, and it ends up looking like a chessboard. It's not. It's also bilaterally symmetrical, so you only have to draw one side. Thank you. First thing you could have done was draw a box. And then, because I know some of you are too narrow, some are a little, you know. Whatever it takes to.
It's good.
You can tell if it's not direct front portion. I mean, you know. Looks like Okay. What is this telling you? Practice. This is what I do with staff meetings, senior management meetings. You know, oh, he's really busy. On the edge of the notes you're supposed to be taking, kind of thing. Sue does
found
poems at seminars. I do. Gets the teacher and all that kind of stuff. So. Okay. All right. Several of you have asked. This is kind of important. We're going to finish today with. What do you do? Okay. We went in the classroom about a little bit last week. What do you do in the field? Right? All this, visually in one, Michael. All of this involves doing this in the field, right? Otherwise, so, how do you deal with in the field? Well, Sue and I are going to both tell you what we do in the field. And we both, if you ever notice, we're different. We have different opinions on everything, you know. And she does. I start from one place, and everything feeds off of that. And she starts from another place, and everything feeds off of that. Okay? But you want to do yours first? No.
Right in the rain notebook, but I will use a right in the rain pen.
A little
tack bag is waterproof?
It's pretty much waterproof. The inside is, so I wouldn't spill, I wouldn't want my water bottle to spill in here. And it, the way it covers, the outside material is pretty waterproof, is waterproof as well. I've had 100% waterproof bags, and the zippers are a pain to deal with. They're really hard to get in and out of, but I have had those.
We did 6 miles in a driving rainstorm, a Sue's hiking book, carrying these with my camera inside, and the camera was dry at the end of the 6 miles. And it was a, not just a gentle, it was blowing like crazy.
My notebook was all puffed up.
Well, you were writing.
I know.
Okay, so Sue starts with her notebook. Everything was on, mine starts with my camera. Everything, I'm a photographer, so everything comes from carrying a camera. So I'll never be in a field without a camera. Here's my vest. You can wash it once a year whether you need it or not. And this is a photo vest, and this was made by Donkey.
I just find that vest too long for me. And so
But it has pockets that are made for lenses. So the lenses, and they're reinforced, so the lens will actually ride in your pocket. Here's my 3x5 notebook when I remember to bring it. Okay. A compass, a knife, you know, for survival. Filters are over here, lens filters, we'll talk about those next week. A pair of gloves, and a garbage bag. Heavy duty, hefty garbage bag.
Hefty steel sack.
Hefty steel
sack.
Never
leave home without a hefty steel
sack. And then,
sack.
That's the thing. Yes.
To cover up everything.
But I'm usually carrying a tripod, and you can simply put the camera on a tripod, and you put the hefty bag over the whole thing, and it's fine. Okay?
Depending on how big your camera is, those shower caps that you get free in hotels,
oh, yeah,
they work
work
really
great for, you just cut it over, over there. It looks really,
it looks really dorky, but.
And then and this, and this is the same thing, same bag. I have a bigger one, but my camera will fit in here with a 400 millimeter lens. It fits in here, and that's fine. And I can carry it or carry it on the tripod. It gets kind of a pain carrying it on the tripod if you're going 10 miles. But the other thing, when you have a tripod, if you buy a tripod that doesn't have a carrying strap, this gets really old after a while, especially with the camera on it. This is a piece of cake, you know, with the, obviously with the legs in. But.
And I never carry my mug bag.
Well, I know you don't. But I do, like this. Well, yours drags on the ground anyway. But this is very easy to carry, like this. There's some new technology out, which we're going to try, but and you carry it like this, and it's very stable, you know, and big investment. And, but since it fits right on here, you can carry your lunch or whatever you want, everything else in here like this. So if I'm going out, we're not coming back all day, this is it. Okay? And usually not cotton shirts we use.
Those real quick dry shirts.
Quick dry shirts, so you don't, you know, not sweating and getting through all. This is cotton, and that's never any drawing stuff because I do that
when we get home.
When I get home.
Or when we get back to camp.
If you wanted to do, if you weren't do that, then you put it all in here, or else you use one of these. You know, this is a good. I have one of these field bags that has all my drawing material in it, but. Remember, you can write and photograph, you can draw and write, but you can't write, draw, and photograph at the same time. You simply can't do it. It's too much. The Nagi art's a pet mule. Right? So you decide what is your focus, and that's what you lead with for your field work. The rest, everything else feeds off of that. Yep.
What's the source of your waterproof bag?
What?
What's your source?
They're called Timbuktu.
Oh, yeah.
You can go on their website. It's spelled TIMBUK2.
Smokies?
Well, I was hiking in the Smokies, and this woman came up to me, and she said, "My son designed those bags." And I was like,
oh. And then he sold the company.
Yeah, that's a California company. But you can get some great deals on these bags through a place called Sierra Trading. And they, a lot of times they'll have them 50% off or more.
And I have a pouch here too, but this carries batteries. Either batteries for the camera, extra batteries, or batteries for flat, or batteries, so I can get to them right away. And Sue has a fancy leather one, mine is just...
This is for my notebook.